Have you ever wondered what would happen to your free NAS storage pools if you have to reinstall the NAS operating system? Would the storage pool data survive the reinstallations? The reason I'm doing this is because I had a bad experience with Windows Server 2019 storage space. For some reason, I had to do the reinstallation of the Windows Server. And you know what? All my storage space went missing after that. I could not recover any of the data, and all of my data was lost in the process. So before I'm committed to TrueNAS, I have to find out about this, and hopefully you know about it as well. So watch my video and see what happens when I destroy my FreeNAS virtual machine operating system and see if my data was still there after I reinstalled TrueNAS. I know TrueNAS is still in beta, but it's good enough for me to find out my answer. So if you have some time, let's watch my video and find out about it as well. I use FreeNAS as a virtual machine, but with the bare metal system, the result should be the same, right? I guess. What I'm going to do is to delete my current FreeNAS virtual machine and replace it with brand new TrueNAS Core V12 with a similar configurations as my current one. Before doing the actual upgrade, let's take a look what I currently have with my FreeNAS virtual machine. The operating system software version is 11.3-U3.2, which is the latest production version of FreeNAS. It is assigned with 6V CPU and 20GB of RAM. The system consists of two storage pools. One is called Media Pool, which is a Stripe pool of two 2TB VDEVs. Another one is called Personal Pool, which is a mirror pool of two 1TB disks. The network interface is connected to VMware ESXi virtual switch that has two physical Intel network adapter uplink. Now, let's take a look at what service I currently have enabled. Smart and SMB. For the SMB 5 sharing network, I have a couple of share as shown, as you see. I don't have any other plugins enabled with my current system. In regard to the hard disk controller, I have one 4-port Intel SATA controller, which is enabled pass-through for a FreeNAS. Now I'm going to shut down the old FreeNAS virtual machine and take a look at the system setting so I can create a new virtual machine that basically has the same setting as the old one. All right. Now I'm taking notes of what setting I currently have with this old FreeNAS virtual machine, and I think I'm ready to delete these machines once I got everything down on my notes. Ready to delete? Yes. First thing first, I need to upload my TrueNAS Core V12 ISO 5 to VMware ESXi. Once it is finished, we are going to register a new virtual machine with basically the same setting as my previous one. Now let's go ahead and create a new virtual machine for TrueNAS Core V12. This time, we're just gonna have to make sure that we select the FreeBSD12 for the guest operating system version and the correct data store to install to. In the customize setting page, I go ahead and put back the same setting that I had with my previous FreeNAS virtual machine, except for the fact that I'm gonna give it 20GB of data storage, which I think is more than enough for my usage environment. For SATA hard disk controller, I make sure I add audio device and select the correct storage controller unit. when everything looks good, I hit finish to create a brand new virtual machine for TrueNAS Core V12. All I need to do is to double click to power the virtual machine up and let the installation process begin. It's pretty straightforward from here on. And after about 5 minutes, I have fresh, brand new TrueNAS Core V12 up and running. I'm so happy. But where are my storage pools? I don't see them in the GUI. It doesn't seem that they automatically reappear in the GUI, but all you need to do is to import them back into the new TrueNAS system manually. And after about 5 to 10 minutes, I was able to recover all my storage pools by importing them back in. But I found out that all users that I created earlier version system are gone, and all the custom access control lists are there, but not associated with any user or group from previous version. But this is expected. Nothing is wrong about this. I can always recreate user and ACLs, but at least my data is still intact. And I think I fall in love with this TrueNAS and VMware ESXi combination here, where I don't have to spin up the bare metal system just to run a NAS server for my home usage. You now have the same answer as I do, that it is safe to do the reinstallation or transferring to a different system without losing any data from the pools. All right, that's it for this video. Don't forget to leave any comments or questions about this video. Your input is really appreciated. And as a bonus, I will show you how to put together a home lab system that is built around VMware ESXi and TrueNAS Core. So please stay tuned and subscribe to my channel for more videos just like this. Bye for now.